Hello and a very warm welcome. Your Austrian race reaction, a snooze fest turned into an epic with the last 20 laps. George Russell claims his second victory in Formula One after Norris and Max have contact. Max has done everything he needs to do. A shit pit stop by Red Bull literally creates a race that should never have been there. Max is dominating and Red Bull mess up the pit stop. And they give us a race. And unfortunately, Max has to take the blame for the incident that caused them both to get a puncture. High drama at Austria. And we need a bit of rivalry in F1. These two, good mates, fuck that man. Hopefully, they're not best of mates now. Kissing and cuddling in the driver's room and driver pen. Let's have a bit of rivalry and spice. Yeah, wow. Unbelievable, a really average, poor race created by a bad Red Bull pit stop, and then we had 20 laps of decent. We start the race, we had contact between Leclerc and Piastri. Leclerc had damage, had to change his wing. Alonso ran into the back of Joe, gets a penalty. Lewis got a penalty for exceeding coming into the pits. Perez then gets a penalty for speeding in the pits. We saw a great ding-dong battle between Alpine again. Wow, Gasly coming out on top in that one. And then the changing point of the race. Max is comfortable. He's absolutely comfortable. He's got like an 8-second lead. He comes in and it's a slow stop. Norris then feeds off that. The gap has gone from 8 seconds to DRS gap. And Norris... it was crazy. He was putting pressure on, but his moves were kind of kamikaze. Like, he couldn't get the job done. When the pressure was on, Norris couldn't get the job done. And he was doing these late moves. It was inevitable that they were going to crash. F1 Fan Gamer subscriber called it. They're going to crash. And it happened. Norris says Max is moving in the braking zones. In the actual incident, Max definitely moves across, and they both get a puncture. Wow, and Max got the penalty for it. So let's run down the order. George Russell wins his second race win for Mercedes. Mercedes, their third podium in a row. They are making progress. Of course, he's gifted the win today, but he's there to take it. So, I mean, yeah, it happens in racing. You get a bit of luck. Today was Russell's lucky day. Second, Oscar Piastri. And just think, if he doesn't get a track limits penalty yesterday, he wins the race today. And that's the difference. P3, Carlos Sainz. He's had a strong weekend for Ferrari. Fourth comes Lewis Hamilton with a pretty average weekend. Slammed by the male model all weekend. Gets a penalty for crossing the white line. P5, Max. What an eventful race for him. I mean, he's done everything. And he's got a right to be angry with Red Bull because they've cost him a win today. He's got the mega pole lap. He's done a perfect race. Perfect race. Created an 8-second gap. The team cost him dearly. And then he's got a fight. He's got the pressure on. Moving around in the braking area. And then in the actual incident, he comes left. It's Max's fault more than Lando. Yeah, I have to say it how I see it. I could easily come on here and blame Lando because I don't like him. But the reality is, that's not what happened. Max came across. P6, Nico Hülkenberg. Sensational. My driver of the day. P6 in the Haas. Superb. 7th, Sergio Perez. Honestly, his contract should be torn up and ripped. Max, let's have a look at his race. I mean, 10-second penalty for the contact with Norris. He's lost a minute coming back to the pits. Slow pit stop. And he still finishes ahead of Perez. Perez 7th. What is that all about? Nowhere. 8th, Kevin Magnussen. Superb. I said in my preview, watch out for Kevin Magnussen. He's good round Austria. And he gets points. 9th, Daniel Ricciardo. 2 points for him. Very good. Very good, Daniel Ricciardo. 10th, Gasly. Again, Alpine in the points. 11, Charles Leclerc. First corner incident, Piastri's cut across him. It's no one's fault, just the first lap, but that's ruined Leclerc's race. 12, Esteban Ocon had an amazing battle with Gasly. Again, Ocon, though, pushed his teammate off. 13th comes Lance Stroll. Aston Martin, no pace. 14th, 1 foot one. He's had quite a bad weekend. Struggled with the car. 15th, Alex Albon. 16th, Valtteri Bottas. 17th, Guan Yu Zhou with an awful weekend. 18th, Fernando Alonso. An awful weekend. Sargeant, 19th. And then the only DNF of the race, Lando Norris. McLaren keep bottling these opportunities to win. They shouldn't have even been in the fight today because Max did a perfect race till the pit stop. The pit stop created the drama. And yeah, McLaren again should win the race today and they don't capitalize. And time again, we keep seeing this. Norris has to win that race today. He has to win that race. He's in DRS. There's three DRS zones and he couldn't get the job done. The reality is he couldn't get the job done. He was making like F1 gameplay, really. Just dive bombing Max on every occasion. He'd never look comfortable as if he was going to make the move stick. And that's me being unbiased and trying to give a fair opinion. Norris did not look like he was going to get the job done. Max was moving in the braking area, but he comes left, so it's Max's fault. And then Max almost tries to, as Norris comes round, he almost tries to squeeze him off again. So Max has to take the blame for that one. Norris, again, another missed opportunity. He's won in Miami, but McLaren have to start winning races, honestly. Piastri second is a positive. He's been really good in the sprints, not so good in the main races. But yeah, McLaren, I would say another opportunity gone begging. It was a shocking Austrian Grand Prix, but the last 20 laps was so good. George Russell is a race winner. We see contact between Norris and Max. Fastest lap was Max. Star of the race, I'm giving it Hülkenberg. Race rating, it was zero. And now it's gone up to, I mean, let's be real. Apart from the last 20 laps, it was a really poor race. I'd probably boost it to a 6, but yeah, interesting. I cannot wait for Silverstone. Gloves off. Silverstone crowd, they're going to be boo. Norris is going to be full of momentum at home. Can't wait, honestly. Bring on Silverstone. This is what we need in F1. A bit of rivalry, a bit of spice. Join me for driver ratings tomorrow.